stay with me? Sometimes there's traction in the spiritual. Sometimes you have these kids who from their children knew they was in the wrong body. Because their spirit is not the body they were born in.
Yes.
I know you all think it's the biggest sin in the world and God don't deal with that. I don't know what God you deal with, he deals with you.
Yes.
So sometimes, deep as I close, a person's spirit sometimes goes for God's own glory with the wrong gender.
Yes.
And then people become attracted to the spirit. Mm-hmm. So you have a male spirit in a woman's body.
Yes.
And then you have another female with a female spirit in a female body. And the attraction then becomes spiritual.
Yes.
There, God.
Yes, God.
I know I ain't got my head now. I was doing good till I said that. Listen, too many of you hide in church who struggle with these things. I want to make you free. Sometimes you are born this way. What Jesus said? Some eunuchs were born to be eunuchs. You know what a eunuch is?
Teach
it. You know what a eunuch is? Have you ever researched that? A eunuch is what the kings used to do when they took the men, they would tear off their genitals so they couldn't sleep with their wives. So eunuchs are people who can't function in the gender they were born in. And Jesus, some people were born that way. You don't believe that in church. Come on, give these people a break. Let's give life a break, man. Are we here together?
Yes.
Are we here together?
Yes.
I love you, amigo.
Love you too.
I know you all can get on this case when I leave out the door. And get it. Close the door. Don't let them mind you. But listen, I am giving you the love of God.
Yes.
I am giving you the truth of God.
Yes.
This is a level of truth. See, that's why I said I got to go. That's why I said I'm an apostle. I'm going to tell you stuff that's always been true that you didn't know.
Yes.
You got it, Dick? So stop. Look at it. You're a criteria from another perspective now. Stop judging people you don't understand.
Yes.
You were born a liar. You can't tell the truth for Christ's sake. You are a lying spirit. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and give you peace. The Lord prosper in everything that you do. I release grace on you right now. Oh, that's what I share. I release grace on you right now. Grace to prosper and move forward. In Jesus' name, you receive it. Say amen.
Amen.
Now, I'm going to take off. Don't sit down. I'm going to share something with you. I want you to stand because I believe it brief. I tell you what I tell you on Sunday, Pastor Willow. See, the things I do, I rest in God. I had a $237,000 bill there hanging over my head. Just to be careful. My wife is a witness. 2 weeks ago, I went to the Lord. The Lord told me I can't do nothing for you. I went to New York to preach in a conference, and I sold well. Like, well, my wife said, you sold too much money. That's why we have a financial problem. But we don't have a financial problem. That's just in my mind. So, I sold. Do you know that after the Lord told me he couldn't help me, for the last few months I've been before God for debt cancellation? So we see wherever I go, whatever they ask for. I got a phone call on Friday morning. It was Friday morning up in the hotel in New York. And the guy says, because I had to call him because they were threatening to garnish my bank account. And they told me that the less they would take for me was $900 a month. That's a lot of money for people like me. I know you're rich, man. And I got a phone call. I prayed, and the guy said, I said, man, listen, I'm calling because I don't know what to do. I said, why are you concerned about this thing? You have zero payment. Listen, I was under so much pressure. Didn't tell him, but I didn't know how to tell him. Where were your financial $900 a month? And if he didn't, it was going to garnish your bank account. Because it's the federal government. And I told him, I checked it again. I think you made a mistake. True. I called my wife up after they checked it 3 times. And I was just sobbing on the phone. Because when God does something for you like that, it breaks you. All the things you got to fight for, the devil tell you you're doing the wrong thing, and God ain't pleased with you. Anybody understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
And it broke me, and I called my wife weeping on the phone. And she thought I was weeping because I missed her, but I had a better deal. You see what I'm saying? And I said, baby, they just told me we had zero payment on that $230,000 $37,000 debt. And the guy, I got the papers in the mail yesterday.